Hi guys, and welcome back to Sketch by Sketch. Today I'm here with a new video, and today I'm going to be designing a new dress for my original character, Olivia. I found this sewing pattern, it's vintage. I'm not sure exactly what year, it says 1950s, and I think it's really pretty, actually. So I want to kind of just use my character in that dress as the inspiration and just kind of recreate it. I'm not saying that I'm going to completely, you know, redo my character's design. I just want to have a little bit of fun and maybe draw some of these patterns. And there's a few more that I might do as well. So we'll just see what we do here. I'm kind of just wanting to do a spread and a sketch with me. So let's get drawing. And I'm just going to start. I might want to move that over a little. And I'm pretty used to drawing my character. I know her face shape. She almost has like a Pocahontas type of a face shape if you're comparing it to something. So I'm just gonna get that in quickly because the focus of this is going to be the dress. So, and I want to put her in a similar pose as the model because I think it's really cute. Okay, I think I have a nice base here, so let's just start drawing in the features. It's actually been a hot minute since I've actually drawn this character. She's super fun though. I'm just sketching with a Crayola pencil. I've been sketching with these a lot lately, I don't know why. I just kind of found an old set of them and I love sketching with them, so that's what I've been using. Add some color to your sketches without really having to put any extra detail or work into it, so. Okay, I think she looks really pretty so far. Okay, and now I'm just going to draw her hair and we will draw the dress. Alright, super cute. Alright, now that I've got the hair in pretty much. Okay. Now for this dress. It has a kind of like an oval neck. Now this dress is just very delicate and soft, and that's why I really love that. And it's got a frilly detail. And how I draw the frillies, you really just go in a squiggly pattern, but following the seam that I've already created, so I don't really do anything technical there. And it's got a puff sleeve. There's a little in the way. It's okay though. And then it's got a band around that, and then the same little frillies. Okay, and now it has kind of like a corset right under the bust, so draw that, and then it's got a bow. I just love this dress, I kind of want it. And then on the waist. They have a matching little bow. That's so adorable. Okay, and then now it just kind of is a simple flare. It's not too puffy, but it does have a little bit of flare to it. And then it has a scalloped edge on the bottom. I'm just going to draw the dress a little shorter just so we can see a little bit of a scalloped edge. Okay, now I'm just going to put in some lines where the dress would fold. It's going to fold a lot more right here where the top meets the bottom. Okay, and then there's going to be little flowers on the dress. Again, I'm doing these kind of messy just to kind of make it look a little more effortless and a little bit like simpler in design and just to look a little bit more soft. Okay, and now I'm going to add the arms. I probably should have done that already. Okay. I think that is so, so cute. I'm not sure if I want to add color. I kind of just like that it's a sketch because a lot of the things I've been putting in my sketchbook lately have been more finished pieces with color, so I kind of just like the sketchy aspect of this one, so I might leave it, but I'll add a little extra shading. Alright. I'm just gonna add some flowers in the background. I think these flowers are so cute. I know they're kind of messy and they don't all look the same, but I think the type of flower is just so cartoony and cute. I'm gonna add some hearts in with it. Okay, now let's go ahead and move on. That was so fun, and do some more designs from these patterns, and so let me find the next one. Okay, the next one I have is this, it's just a pattern for a corset, but I thought we could kind of just have fun and design the rest of the dress from that. So let's go ahead and get a face. I'm going to give her a really like hourglass shape just so that the corset really stands out. I'm going to draw curly hair here. I'm not exactly sure why, I just kind of started going for it. So this one will have some curly hair here. And again, this is just kind of sketching. This isn't a particular character or anything, just kind of fun. Okay, now let's actually start drawing the corset that is the inspiration of this. So first I just need to get the shape, I guess. So it has two parts, it looks like, kind of held together with a bow. So the first part is just the strap. And then we have just it kind of continuing down and creating the neckline, so. And then of course it just creates a shape after that. And it goes down, kind of, not really sure, just kind of round it off. Okay, I think that's really cute. And now, just for the actual details, then we have the structure. I'm gonna go ahead and color in the bows. And then it has kind of like a trim on it, so I'm gonna draw that in. And the bone. Lots of details on something like this for sure. And now the string, stringing it together. And then of course it is tied off in a bow, and this is going to be a more floppy bow than that, so it's going to look a little more like the one over here. Wow, I think that is so cute. This one has kind of like a swirly pattern on it, so I'm just going to kind of add that in. Since I'm not coloring, I don't have to be super precise on the details. And now we're worksheeting. Alright, now I get to decide what I want to do with the rest of this, what kind of dress we want to put on underneath. And I think we're gonna go with a shirt kind of like this and add some frills. And I'm gonna put her hands behind her back, I think. So just kind of add the sleeve and put it, keep it behind. So I want this dress to be a little bit fluffier. Okay, and I'm just going to start making the lines a little darker. I'm gonna add kind of like a center split in this dress where it will be the same color as the center of the corset if I were to color it. And then of course just the fabric of the dress like that. I think this one is really cute as well. Honestly, I'm not sure where this video is going. We're just kind of drawing random things today, and I think that's really fun. So I'm not exactly sure what even to title this video, but I really like all these sketches and the way they're turning out. Let's keep going. Next up, I'm gonna draw this dress right here. I think it's really cute, and I just like the design. I think it's a little bit different than something I would normally just draw. So let's get into that. I'm gonna sharpen my pencil. Thank you. I guess we've kind of went away from drawing my characters. My whole intent for this video was just to do this, and then I kind of, you know, did it quickly, I guess, and wanted to keep drawing some of these sewing patterns, so I guess we'll just keep doing that and draw different characters rather than just the one. But I'm not sure what time period this dress is. I just really like it. Just so simple, but it's so pretty at the same time. Adding some makeup. Okay. And I think I'll use the hairstyle in a picture. Now this dress is not particularly tight. It does kind of, you know, follow the form of the body, but it's not going to be skin tight. So I'm just kind of keeping that in mind as I kind of put it around the base that I've made. Just kind of letting it loosely sit rather than making it very tight like this one. Okay, now this seam goes kind of like this upwards. And then it just kind of makes all these little flares because the fabric gets a good bit looser at the bottom. And then this seam goes in that same direction, so this should probably be a straight line through there. So. And then the neckline meets that seam in the middle. Makes it really interesting and pretty. And it has the inward seams like that, so. There's that one. Super. Okay, this is the last one I'm gonna do. I think this one's really cool, so let's get right into it. just drawing these faces kind of quickly. I'm not really spending too much time on that part of it, you know. I'm trying to give each of these characters almost like a personality just from looking at them, just so they don't all look the same. So definitely just going for different looks for each of the characters. Now that this dress is a little odd as far as the shape of it. So I'm gonna start with the neckline, and it just kind of creates a flap like that, and then a second one. So it just kind of do the both on the same side and do the other to match. Kind of like that, and then this side wraps around, creates a button. And then there's a nice bow on this side, and then it just kind of uses some of the fabric, I guess, to kind of wrap around. And then it flares out in these really cute pleats. So I'm going to create the buttons down the dress as well. Okay. And the arms can just kind of go to the side. And now I need to kind of create a hairstyle. Alright guys, I hope you guys had a fun time hanging out today, just doing some sketches. Again, this video kind of just didn't really even have a theme, just sketching a bit, and I thought it was really fun. If you want to see more of me drawing patterns, turning them into drawings, then let me know, and I would love to do that. Or if you would like me to color these sometime. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye!